Welcome to our Winter 24 edition, which is all about foundations. Building a business is a lot like building a house. There are the choices that you make that make the house your home, like the room layouts, the paint colors, and even what appliances to install. But what you can build and how easy it is depends on the foundations. Is the ground solid? Is there reliable water supply, electricity, and internet? What raw materials, glass, stone, wood, are actually available for you to build with? These foundations, to a large extent, determine what and how you can build. And that's why here at Shopify, we know that delivering on great foundations is the most important thing we do to help entrepreneurs architect exactly what they want, bringing their businesses to life using powerful building blocks like data models, business logic, APIs, and high-performance infrastructure. In this edition, we're excited to share capabilities that strengthen our commerce foundations and deliver on the diverse needs of the businesses and developers who rely on Shopify every day. So let's start digging into some of the most exciting new foundations. We'll start today where most merchants start on Shopify, with creating and merchandising their products. How your products show up in your store is really important, possibly the most important thing that can drive conversion for your business. And while Shopify has always made it easy to set up simpler products, we knew we needed to do more for merchants selling large and complex product catalogs. And so we've made some big updates. First up, and I know how many of you are going to be excited about this one, we've improved the foundations of our product model by addressing a long-standing merchant frustration, the 100 product variant limit. Let's look at an example. So assume today I am selling board shorts. I offer 10 sizes, 2 inseams in 2 colors, and that's a product with 40 variants total. But say this season I want to add 6 new colorways. This relatively simple catalog expansion means that my variant count increased significantly from 40 up to 160. This kind of thing often happens to merchants who offer products that come in many different sizes, colors, and materials. They quickly hit that variant limit, but not anymore. Available today in Dev Preview, we've increased our variant limit from 100 to 2,000 to make it easier to create and maintain complex products with high variant counts without having to work around the limitations of the system. We're first working with our partner ecosystem to make this update smooth, and we will be rolling out access to 2,000 variants to merchants progressively throughout 2024. So now that you can have up to 2,000 variants, let's talk about how to display and merchandise that expansive catalog. We know that shoppers expect to see images and videos in the exact color that they are looking to buy on the product page. But businesses also need dedicated URLs and SEO tags for each color so they can target their campaigns properly. You might want to include individual colorways in different collections tailored to promotions or seasons. Modeling all the colors as one product makes this hard to achieve. That's why today we are launching the Shopify Combined Listings app in early access, which allows Shopify Plus merchants to better merchandise a parent product that comes in a bunch of options, with each option as a child product with its own description, rich media carousel, and dedicated descriptive URL, but all appearing on a single product page as one listing. We've also made some big updates related to the way products are created and managed in Shopify for all merchants across all plans. Shopify's current out-of-the-box approach for creating and managing product data is one size fits all across industries and categories. That's why we've done all the behind-the-scenes work to improve the way your products are created and classified on Shopify, which maps every product category to a rich set of associated product attributes. In early access today, we're introducing a new standardized product taxonomy. As you can see, as I add a product in the admin, the new category card on the product page automatically applies category-specific product attributes, reducing the time and manual effort that is required to create products and allowing you to store more complete and consistent data across your catalog. Notice that the card was able to auto-detect the product category and the colors of the product. Enriching your product data with these standard categories and attributes helps generate variants and collections, helps optimize the search and filtering experience on your storefront, and integrates all the way through to channels like Google and Meta to make your products more discoverable. Now, let's chat about the online store. We all know getting a basic storefront up and running on Shopify is easy, but building a storefront that matches the precise vision you want for your brand starts to become more complex. That's why we're making foundational improvements to how you edit and customize your store to tell your brand story exactly the way you want. So let's walk through an example here. Today, when I look at, let's say, text blocks in my theme, I might notice that each text block has different features. Sometimes this is actually a good thing, and it actually gives me some flexibility, but more often than not, it throws me off that the text blocks don't all work the same way across the board. So why does this happen? Well, today, blocks are defined in each section file, which means that if a theme needs to have a text block in 10 different sections, they need to re-implement this text block 10 separate times. Now, with reusable blocks, developers will only have to define theme blocks once and then repurpose them across sections to eliminate redundant work and coding, ensuring a consistent experience for merchants. So a single block now can work consistently no matter where in the theme it is. We're also launching the ability to nest blocks up to 8 layers deep. Previously, blocks couldn't be nested inside other blocks, making more complex layouts like this multi-column section more rigid. See how I'm not able to change the order, and there are so many extra settings here as a result. With the ability to nest blocks, the multi-column section can now expose individual blocks for image, text, and link, which gives merchants the freedom to reorder or add additional blocks in each column. These updates are in developer preview today and make it so much easier for developers to build themes that work the way users expect while giving them more flexibility and helping them stay on their theme's upgrade path. Now, let's talk about a major update for selling to your B2B customers. Sales reps are an essential part of most B2B businesses. They're the boots on the ground that drive revenue and build customer relationships with your most important accounts. Available today, Shopify now supports sales reps in the admin. With a few simple clicks, you can set permissions for these B2B users to only access the accounts that are assigned to them. Let me show you how it works. I have a new sales rep, Sarah, and I want her to be able to place orders and access customer information for only her customers. In settings, I'm going to assign her a role I previously created, and this role uses the new restrict permissions to assigned company locations access control. It's easy to set up roles with these permissions so that I can save time each time I add a new rep. Now I'm going to assign Sarah to her accounts from the company's page. So when Sarah logs in, she only sees the orders, customers, and companies that are assigned to her accounts. This product is foundational for all merchants, not just those who sell B2B, because it's the first time we're supporting record-level access control across the Shopify platform. So today, developers can use the new permissions API to build apps for B2B. But in the future, this could also extend to all merchants for things like making sure regional employees only see customers in their own region, or for merchandisers to only have access to the products for the brands that they're allowed to manage. Now, let's talk about how your back office logistics extend through to storefront and checkout for inventory, orders, and fulfillment. Today, we're introducing fulfillable inventory. This ensures that shoppers browsing your store and going through checkout only see market-specific, real-time, accurate views of in-stock inventory in their region. So let's say I split my inventory between the US and the UK, and I only want customers from each country to see the local fulfillable inventory, both on the storefront and down through checkout, building trust and resulting in more satisfied customers. And while we're talking about checkout, Shopify has the highest converting checkout in the world. Scaling and large businesses need the most flexible and customizable platform to create unique checkout experiences that are fast, powerful, and secure. And that's where checkout extensibility comes in. Checkout extensibility is the way to customize your checkout using app-based customizations that are flexible, upgrade-safe, and integrated with Shop Pay. Now, you can also customize the entire buyer journey from checkout down to a completed order that lands on the thank you page using checkout extensibility. There are now over 90 new apps available today that are built for checkout extensibility, enabling upsells, loyalty programs, and post-purchase surveys that were previously only achievable through custom code in checkout.liquid and would require your checkout to fall off the upgrade path. Today, we've also released 14 new checkout APIs and updates, including advanced branding controls and more ways to customize delivery options. Speaking of which, performance is the bedrock foundation of commerce. Speed equals conversion, and it's something we obsess over. In the last year, we've reduced the initial checkout page load time by 95% globally. 95%. In the same period, we also reduced our storefront page load time by over 35%. And we've expanded our web infrastructure to 300 points of presence globally. However, we knew we could take storefront performance a step further by empowering all of you with the tools to improve the experience for your customers. Beginning today, we are excited to announce that all Liquid storefronts have access to a new web performance dashboard where you can get trusted insight into your real user experience. Using the dashboard, you can analyze and monitor your customers' experience across three industry standard core web vitals, which can help positively impact your store's page ranking and conversion. So that's all great, but let's get back to the post-checkout customer experience. Obviously, giving buyers the flexibility to return items is a good buyer experience and something they expect. But for merchants, returns can mean additional costs and potential loss in revenue. That's why we're rolling out exchanges. Now, merchants can create, track, and manage exchanges for any order in Shopify, allowing them to have a great post-purchase experience while also retaining revenue. And they can trust Shopify to correctly calculate refunds, payments, taxes, and inventory adjustments automatically. We enabled exchanges through a new settings page called Test Drive, which is a new tool for Plus merchants to train staff and test new capabilities and APIs with your existing apps and integrations before rolling it out to your production stores at a time that's right for you. But customers want to engage and re-engage with brands for more than just exchanges after they place an order. This is why we have customer accounts, which are a home to our merchants' most loyal customers. Today, customers face a fragmented experience that requires multiple portals and logins for each app they use, like for returns, subscriptions, loyalty programs, and so on. With customer accounts extensibility in developer preview today, developers can now build extensions and create brand new logged in experiences for merchants and their customers. This is built on the same developer platform foundation as checkout extensibility, which ensures all of the familiar capabilities and components of checkout extensibility work seamlessly with new customer accounts. In addition to that, today we are introducing store credit so that merchants can issue, track, and report accurately on customer store credit in the admin, and developers can create customizable and flexible experiences built on the same primitive, which is now in developer preview. Let's say a merchant was offering free shipping for orders of $75 or more for a limited time, but the item a valuable customer wanted was out of stock. As a goodwill gesture, the merchant could issue $10 in store credit, which the customer can use to pay for that item at checkout when it's back in stock. So, we covered ways to improve the post-purchase experience and help retain customers. But what are we building to ensure you can continue to attract new customers? Well, one of the main ways merchants do this is through ads. But over the past few years, privacy regulations and policies have made it harder and more expensive for brands to get in front of the most interested buyers. That's why we've made some serious improvements to help make your ads more effective and relevant. So first, let's talk about Shopify audiences, which lets merchants generate custom targeted audiences across top ad platforms like Meta, Google, Pinterest, Snapchat, TikTok, and more. With the volume of commerce that happens on Shopify, we are uniquely positioned to put our scale back into the product to help improve digital advertising for all Shopify merchants. In this edition, we've introduced smarter retargeting algorithms with improved boost lists that maximize performance on the top ad platforms. Most merchants using this are seeing retargeting audiences at least double the size. Now let's talk about shop campaigns. This low-lift acquisition program means merchants don't need to fuss about creative assets or complex configuration and targeting, but instead they have a powerful way to pay only for converting customers by setting a cost per acquisition target and letting Shopify do the rest. Now, nothing is more foundational to a business than the balance sheet. And that's why we've made some significant updates to the finance section. Shopify Capital has now been helping merchants thrive and grow for more than 7 years, injecting over $5 billion of funding into businesses when they need it the most. Shopify Term Loans are an iteration of our existing capital offering that provides a more customizable and predictable lending option for merchants looking for fixed payments over a fixed payback period. And starting this month, we're releasing Shopify Line of Credit, which provides flexible on-demand funding that merchants can draw upon whenever the need arises. Finally, let's talk about how we are arming every business to keep them on the cutting edge of digital commerce powered by AI. We launched Shopify Magic in the last edition, and not only were we the first platform to bring AI-generated product descriptions to market with tens of thousands of merchants using this feature to auto-write personalized on-brand content for their product pages, but we've also continued to integrate our suite of free AI-enabled features across key products and workflows. And we're also making progress on Sidekick. Building the world's most useful AI-enabled commerce assistant is a complex journey that demands a complete reimagining of the relationship between data, system architecture, and user-centric design. Starting today, we are rolling out new Shopify Magic features in the Media Editor that use generative AI to make product image editing and enhancement easier than ever, all right here in the admin. With these new AI-powered background editing features, you can select from common style presets for an instant boost of professionalism, or reimagine the scene altogether with a short description of what you'd like to see, or instantly match the background of your existing photo shoots to make your storefront feel more on-brand and cohesive. As new AI technologies and innovations come to market this year, we'll continue to apply them to commerce to keep you on the cutting edge and to make commerce better for everyone. Whether you're just getting started or scaling a business, strong platform foundations are fundamental to your success, and we can't wait to see what you build with them. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy exploring the more than 100 new updates in the Shopify Winter 24 edition today.